Hello everyone and welcome to there's a new tank available somehow, so I'm going to make a video for you video. And today we will be talking about the Titan MK1. I've also released a video on the Titan HN. So yeah, I suggest you check that out as well, because those are the two tanks that you can get in this year's Halloween event. Now, basically this tank, it looks cute, but it's really just a Crusader with minor just differences. It's kind of like almost like a Battle Pass tank, really. Even though those are in tier 6, but like they're always modeled after a different tank and they're very similar, just a little bit different. And it's exactly the same with this tank. This is still very much a Crusader, and even though yes, it can be fun, I find that overall the fact that it just has no armor and everything, like there's a lot of tanks in tier 5 that I would prefer over this tank, let's put it that way. Overall though, you do meet a lot of potatoes in tier 5, which includes me to be fair. So yeah, that does help when you drive this tank, and overall that's just something to keep in mind. That being said though, I will go over the stats with you and everything. Basically I will compare it to the normal Crusader for obvious reasons. Without equipment and all of that, both have a DPM of 1333, both have a penetration of 130, both have an alpha of 90, a rate of fire of 14.81, and both have a reload of 7.1 seconds because of that. Both have two shells in their clip and shoot one at a time, both have a caliber of 57, and both have a shell velocity of 892. Now, with the aim time, that is where things start to get different, and that sounds like there's so much difference. There's really not. The aim time on the Titan MK1 is 1.54, and the aim time on the Crusader is 1.72. They both have a dispersion of 0.308, basically the dispersion on the move, rotation and the turret is 0.15 for both. And then the Titan MK1 has 0.08 and the Crusader has 0.06. Both tanks have a gun depression of 12 degrees and a gun elevation of 20 degrees, and of course an aiming arc of 180 degrees. Both go 50 kilometers per hour forwards, 22 kilometers per hour backwards. They have an engine power of 400. Now the power to weight ratio on the Titan MK1 is 18.27, where it is 18.75 on the Crusader. The effective HP per ton is 20.3 on the Titan MK1, where it's 20.8 on the Crusader. 18.3 on the MK1 and 18.8 on the Crusader, and 13.1 on the Titan MK1 and 13.4 on the Crusader. To me those numbers never mean much, but as they are part of the sets and as they are different, I'm going to tell you them anyway. The terrain resistance is exactly the same for both tanks, and the traverse is 44 degrees for the Titan MK1 and 40 degrees for the Crusader. Both have a camo rating of 29% while still and moving, and after shooting they have a camo rating of 8% both for after shooting and standing still. And basically that's almost all sets. I added a little bit of a fragment to this video because I had like it's potato gaming at tier 5. But this is something that I found happens very often. You are a Crusader, pretty much anyone, anything that farts in your general direction will pen you and take HP from you. And that for me is the main reason why, like, this tank is not so bad, because you meet potatoes and then you can do stuff like this before they pull back and everything. But like I said, basically, if they see you, if they aim at you, they will shoot you and they will pen you, and basically that tends to not go well. So I'm trying to find a position here where I can actually do stuff, but my teammates are in one corner, I can't really do much there. And at the same time, I don't want to overexpose myself here. I do get a little bit of damage again there, but overall I've just done very dismally this game. I'm trying to turn around, my teammates have turned around, and that meant that these two can basically have at us at the back, and yeah, I get absolutely blown up here. And that's the thing with the Crusader, that it's basically there's no armor, which is fine because there's plenty of things that you can do with it in tier 5 if you have a bit of a brain, because that already gives you an advantage over overall potatoes and people that are new to the game and everything. And of course you have crew skills and all of that, that also makes an effect. So the tank itself isn't horrible. It's just, there's nothing really special about it. Yeah, it looks cool. That's the special thing about it. And that's the reason why I will want this tank, because it looks cute. At the same time, if I have to drive a tier 5 tank, this would generally not be the one that I pick to drive, because just like, there's tanks I enjoy more. Even though it looks cute, and even though it's a Halloween tank, and I've overall liked the Halloween tanks that we've gotten. Now, to finish with the last bit of stats that I had left, both have a view range of 253, both have an HP of 620, both have a weight of, well, actually, no, that's different. The Titan MK1 has a weight of 21.89, whereas the Crusader is 21.33, and that's probably to do with the special Halloween armor plates that it has and everything. The turret armor at the front is 65, which is the same for both tanks, but when you get to the sides, the Titan MK1 has 30, whereas the Crusader has 45, and at the rear of the turret it is 30 for the Titan MK1 and 40 for the Crusader. Now, the hull armor for both is frontally 50, on the sides 35, and at the rear it's 35 as well. So that's pretty much all the stats. And like, with this kind of game, this is a good example of the game where, like, I'm not really carrying it everything, but it's working out. I have a bit of a team, they are helping, we are basically moving forwards, and I think that is the key to driving this tank. Mainly just make sure that you are not the primary target. Someone else is going to take the shots for you, but you are there to cheekily get some shots into their rear or sides or whatever. Like in this case, I don't even arrive in time to actually do damage, and I know that I don't have that much HP left, so I kind of just need to be careful because he can one-shot me if he wants to. So that's something to keep in mind as well. Basically, just like assume that anything that shoots at you will pen you and take away the max amount of HP that they can take away. So that's something to just be a little bit careful about. And I wanted to play this tank a little bit sneakily this game, because same with the Titan HN, to be honest, I did not have the best of games here. And in this case, I am going to get a little bit more damage, and then I need to pull back because I just don't want him to shoot me and kill me and make this game not proper to show in a video again. Because that's the thing that kept happening, because this tank, it's just like I said, if they fart in your general direction, they will pen you and they will hurt you. But I had a lovely team this game, so there's that as well. I believe that you can get this tank for free, I think, not entirely certain though, so don't pin me on that, with the Halloween events, and that you would actually need to pay to get the Titan HN and all. Overall though, this tank, it's okay, it's just a Crusader. Slight differences, but it's just a Crusader. So I wish everyone lots of luck with the Halloween events. Basically just have fun in the game, don't get too frustrated at your own team especially. And that's it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed this review, and I'll be seeing you guys later. Bye bye!